So I'm Shreya and I'm a student of economics.
Okay.
I have a couple of questions that I'd like to ask you. So from the scientific community, time and again we hear that in India we lag behind in innovation and there isn't enough governmental support to research. So what do you feel about what the government can do to improve this innovation and research and to garner the potential that India has? So I'd like your thoughts on that. And another question is about being an AI scientist. You could give us some insights on it, and where do you think India stands on AI? Do you think India can be a great innovator, and do you think a disruptive technology can come from India in this field?
First of all, no technology should grow disruptive. It should go protective and safe for the society. There should be no disruption to the peace. And okay, about India, one fact what I have to share is majority of the world research outcomes, wherever they are from, you'll find minimum one Indian from that crew. When you look at it, Indians have one big potential compared to others because our food habits. Our food habits from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, our food habits are unique, especially the idli and sambar. I would have to underline it. But those food items, the ingredients, those tiny such stuff, they contribute so much for our brain functions and yoga, of course. It will train us. And most of the artificial intelligence algorithms and concepts are nature inspired. And when you look out for better understanding of the nature inspired algorithms like cuckoo search algorithm, ancestral algorithms, our ancestors have left so many notes on what exactly the procedures are. They have analyzed every single atom of our nature. So in that way, we have a very good ancestry and heredity in those knowledge. We do not need to read the scriptures. That is not required, and not everyone will have access to it because of the toughness of the languages and so many other reasons. But inbuilt, you are an inbuilt innovator. Every single human being is. As a girl, I am saying every single girl will have a different style of making hairstyles. That even is your innovation. But where you implement your innovation is the impact. And when it comes to artificial intelligence, it has so many openings. It can blend with any technology. Like medicine, pharmacy, structural engineering, civil, tourism and anything. It can blend in with anything. I've chosen AI not because AI is going to be the future of the world, because I like AI and I want to do something so unique in AI that both my contribution and AI will not be forgotten. Because today the world is changing in a very fast mode. So learning AI is important for anyone, any person, because smartphones, about 5 years ago, smartphones were not so much like this in this population, but now every one of us are having a minimum of one or two smartphones. So learn it. Just don't learn it from your regular course. You have so many options to learn, openings to learn, like from the internet. When my mother was there was no internet, there was no computers. But now this 21st century young generation has so many openings. Learn it through NPTEL, learn it through Coursera, edX, all those open source forums, and connect yourself with people who are working through social media. Like in AI, we have so many Facebook groups for AI research. Don't just immerse in distracting social media activities like meme posting, and sharing your day-to-day photograph, that is required. I spend only 1 hour every week for social media. I am in social media. I do take up that, but there is a limit. Just constrain yourself through the positive way. And about the research funding, our government is now giving so many openings, especially for women. If you go through the DST ministry website, you'll find so many funding options. But one thing, no fund will come to your doorstep and stay there until you pick it. You will have to run behind it. You will have to innovate and promote it. no innovation is fruitful if it is, if it, even if it has so much impact, but if it stays inside the lab, there is no in, there is no use of it. Take it to the layman, take it to the end user. That is where a research is of any domain.